I think someone was playing some tricks on me. If you were the one that did this, come forward, comment down below. You just broke the application. So basically, I sent out an email blast to around 100,000 people, and all of a sudden my application was popular. So everybody was basically checking the application, and there's someone that messaged me saying that, I think it's Georgie, he said basically, "Hi Nelson, I've tried to use the app, but it seems I'm getting 5 or 4 errors." And at that point, I'm actually panicking. Visiting this page, which basically sends a REST API call to an endpoint, and then that endpoint itself calls select customer. So basically inside somewhere it calls select, and then basically all these columns, and then from customer, and then this is the actual error. Have a look. Java heap space, out of memory error. Now, what is happening? And for something so small, I'm gonna show you exactly what you should be doing with your SQL queries, basically. So let's go into IntelliJ, and in here, I've got some code, right? So we've got the API. So if I show you the actual controller, so basically, so this is the controller, which basically invokes this get all customers. So this is the first page that you saw. This goes, right, so get all customers, it gets the DAO, invokes the select all customers, and then it performs some mapping. Now, if we look into select all customers, this is an interface which has 3 implementations. Let's look one by one and see how we're going to fix it. So here, customer JDBC data access service. So in here, select all customers. Now, can you see what is the issue? Why are we getting out of memory? No? Okay, cool. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna SSH into the EC2 instance, connect to the database, and then show you what is the problem. So in here, I'm within the EC2 instance and I've connected to the database using a Docker image. And if I do a select count star from customer, check this out. So here, can you see this number here? So in here, you can see that this, it's not a small number. So this is 120,000 customers, right? So I think someone was playing some tricks on me. So if you were the one that did this, please come forward, comment down below. And yeah, you just broke the application. It was a safe one. And hence I'm recording this video just because of you. Because I don't think that within that time frame when I sent the email, this amount of people did register to my application. Well, if it did, then I mean, yeah, that's a lot of numbers, right? But basically, so we can perform a select. So let's just perform a select in here, and let's just add a limit. And in here now, you can see that basically we've got a bunch of records, but to me, these seem like random generated names, right? So Edra, Gaston, Pete. So it seems like someone was playing around with my application. So let's fix this, because this is something that it's very small, but it can cause you big, big trouble in production. Seriously, as you saw, the application, it's not working. So it was working before, but I didn't expect that many load. And now I have to go and fix it so that you can use it. So let's go back to IntelliJ. And basically what is happening is the following. Select all customers. So this is selecting 120,000 records. Yes, that many. Then it basically has this customer role mapper, which its job is to turn the SQL rows into Java objects. So here, 120,000 Java objects. Now, can you see where this is going? Well, it's just filling up the memory heap. Hence, we have out of memory error. So basically, you should never do this. Like, there's no point of view having on this page right here. So this is the one working locally. And you can see that I don't have many customers here. But basically, you should never have 120,000 items displayed on the screen. It doesn't really make sense, right? So what you should do instead is have limit on your queries or pagination. So that is what you should be doing essentially, right? Now, the reason why I didn't do this is because I was teaching and I didn't think about load. But obviously, when you build software to production, then all of these things you have to consider, right? So basically, let's just basically fix some code, deploy, and then you'll see that it works. So currently, as you can see that we have no customers available. This is the one in production. Yes, production. But let's go back to IntelliJ and fix it quickly. And instead of me saying select all of these columns from and then customer, so instead of me selecting 120,000 records, I'm going to add a limit. So this is basically the trick. So this is what you should be doing. So this now will fix the issue for us. Now, obviously, I'm not implementing pagination in here, but this is something that you want to implement. So here I'm just limiting to 1,000 because I don't want to, even 1,000, it's too much, right? So maybe you want to have maybe, I don't know, 50 or 30, something like that. And then through pagination, you load more as you need. But just for demonstration purposes, I'm just going to limit to 1,000 because I know that I can handle 1,000 objects into the memory heap. Cool. So this is JDBC and some SQL. Now, JPA, the fix is, so let's just go here. And if I show you, we do have also the other implementation, which is this one. So find all. So here, this actually takes pageable in here. So what we do is we say page of and then size, and then we can give a size. So how many do we want? Let's just say 1,000 as well. Cool. And then here, what I need to do is I need to, let me just extract this to a variable. And I'm going to say page. And here I'm going to say page dot and then get and then content. Now, if I try and push this, this will fail because I've got CI/CD in place. So let me actually show you. And that is if I run all the tests. So let's just run all tests in here. So if you don't have tests, you'll be in serious trouble. So you can see that a bunch of tests are passing and eventually I'm expecting one to fail. So let's just wait. And there we go. We have one test which failed. Let's just look at it, which is this one. And basically, so this customer is this one. Select all customers. Let's go into it. And you can see that now it's a bit more involved, right? So because we now introduce the pageable and whatnot, so we have to do some mocking. Now, I'm not going to waste time here just showing you how to write a test for this. I'm just going to basically copy and paste because I already did this. So when we invoke find all, we return a page, and basically here we mock the page with one customer inside, which means that when we invoke in here, so we say under test select all customers, then we assert that expected. So what we go back is equal to the customers that the page returns, but also we verify that the page size is equal to 1,000. Cool. So let's just run this. And you can see that this works. Now let's actually commit this and deploy and see whether it fixes the changes. So here I'm going to select all of these changes. So add limit to queries. And let's just say add limit 1,000 to queries. And here I'm going to commit and push. And here I'm going to force push because I was messing about with this. And boom, so that's done. Now let's check it out. So in here I do have CI/CD in place and this is Slack. So as things kick off, I can see basically what is happening instead of me having to go to GitHub. So I've got both, so you can see. But here, have a look. This is the commit. And now you can see that the job has kicked in. And if I click on it, you can see CD deploy backend in progress. If I click on actions, so there we go. Have a look. We have deployment started, building with Maven. And this is basically the job itself. add limit 1,000 to queries. So if I click on it, deploy, it's running 48 seconds and building with Maven, and you can see that it's building with Maven. So at this point, it's going to run the integration tests, the tests, and then push the image to Docker Hub and finally deploy the application. So just sit tight and relax for a second. Cool. So now it's building to Docker, or actually push to Docker Hub, and now it's deploying to Elastic Beanstalk. Let's check this out within AWS console. So let me navigate to it. And here within AWS, you can see that the API, it's severe because it wasn't responding to health checks. So now if I click on it, you can see that it's deploying the new version, which is awesome. And this was the previous running version. Eventually, it will change to the one that we are deploying. So just wait a second or so, and this should finish. And in here, also within Slack, we should receive a message in a second saying that the deployment has completed. And you can see that still updating status. The health is red, which is what you saw. And hopefully we've done everything correct and we should have a success deployment. So you can see that everything was deployed successfully and the job status was success, and hooray. Cool. Now let's go and basically see whether we have deployed the new version. There we go. So now the running version has changed, which is good. And now the moment of truth. So let's go to our production environment in here. And if I reload in here, what should happen? Let's have a look. Fingers crossed, fingers crossed, fingers crossed. Hooray, we've done it. And now you can't really mess about with my application, right? And now the heap can cope with 1,000 elements each time we visit this page because the size is big enough. And as you saw that now, it's not dealing with 120,000, but rather 1,000 each time. And as I said, so the better thing to do here is to implement pagination because it doesn't really make sense for you to have 1,000. Look, this is 1,000 customers here. It doesn't really make sense. So what you want to do is to have pagination, search functionality here as well. And that is a much better solution. But I just wanted to show you the problem because this is something that we do time and time and time again. Select star from, and we never have a limit or we never have a pagination functionality in place. And this can cost you big time. Awesome. If you enjoyed this video, give me a thumbs up. Comment down below, let me know what you want to see next. And if you haven't joined the waiting list for this mega course, do so because it's coming out in about a week or so. This is pretty much it, and I'll catch you in the next one. Assalamu alaikum.